everybody. Thanks for tuning in to Channel Letters and Coffee. On this episode, we're very fortunate to have Tanya from 3M Canada. Welcome, Tanya.
Thank you.
So we'll start off with a bit about who you are, what you do, what company you work for, and any tidbits you want to share. So I'll give you the floor.
Well, thank you. I'm really really excited that you guys reached out for this opportunity. So thank you. So a little bit about myself. So I'm based out of Dartmouth, Nova Scotia. Been with 3M for 20 years, to be 20 years May 1st, so coming up. And I cover the Atlantic provinces for 3M in two of our big divisions. One is transportation safety, and the other one, of course, that is near and dear to our heart, which is graphics markets. So I drive around all these provinces. I typically fly to Newfoundland, but I make sure all of our Sign Association members and, of course, our important 3M customers are taken care of.
Yeah. Wow, amazing. 20 years, I can only imagine.
I know. I started right out of high school. No,
great. Well, you're like me, I guess. I'll pass off the interview to Robert. He's going to ask you the hard-hitting questions. Hopefully, he doesn't put you on the spot. If he does, I'll interject and tell him to mind his own business. So, good luck, Tanya.
Thank you.
Yeah, he makes it sound worse than it is. It's actually just, as we said on the on our emails, it's just like a discussion. You know, with everything we're living right now in this this particular time of our lives, how are you and how is your family? How is that working out for you? What are you finding?
Well, I got to say, we took it pretty seriously from the get-go. I was actually off during that week when everything hit. It was our March break. And I had taken the week off to spend time with the kids, and lo and behold, all of this really unfolded that week. So we've taken it very seriously from day one. The kids have not left the house. And if we need anything, I make my husband Paul go and get it. So I haven't really left the house very much either. So that's kind of a curse and a blessing. You get a little bit of cabin fever and restlessness. And so make sure we're going for walks and we're out in the yard and enjoying the sun as much as possible, but everybody's safe, everybody's healthy. The homeschooling is definitely a challenge. I know I was never meant to be a teacher. It's tested my patience to the brink, but we're getting through it one step at a time.
Good, good, excellent. Tell us about your life in 3M, what you've done, and what are your proudest accomplishments? What are some of the things that you feel, sorry, something's going on. I guess it's your interview that's happening now, apparently. So tell us about some of your proudest accomplishments and some of the things that you really like about the industry and what you see and so on and so forth.
Absolutely. Well, I started at 3M right out of university. At the time, I was living in London, Ontario. I'd lived there for 10 years, and I went to the University of Western Ontario, 3M being one of the largest employers in London, Ontario, where our head office is. I got hired right fresh out of school, right before I finished my final exams, and I started as a customer service rep. So I was processing orders on the desk and worked up to be a supervisor in customer service and then a manager. And about 13 years ago, I was approached about an opportunity to move back home. I had lived in Montreal for 4 years and then in London for 10. So I had been gone a long time, never pictured myself moving back to Nova Scotia, but I took the plunge and moved back and I took this job as a sales rep. Initially, for the first 7 years, I was strictly transportation safety. So that's all your reflective traffic signs, pavement markings. And in 2012, I became a dual rep. And I'm one of the only dual reps in the country where I support two divisions for four provinces. So I've been in the graphics industry since 2012. And I got to say, compared to my transportation safety, where I'm really government heavy, with a lot of provincial engineers and government sign shops, the graphics side is way more exciting and more sexy, and I get to do a lot more things, and I can say a lot more things that I can't do in my government job. So I love all the applications. No 2 days are the same. It seems that all of these graphics manufacturers that we work with are so innovative, on the cutting edge. They love to learn, stay informed. You know, I'm the crazy supplier that comes in. I love to do lunch and learns and training, keeping them up to speed on all the latest products. And we have a lot of products that we release in this division, which is the other greatest thing that I love. We're always coming up with something better and something different. So it's a lot of fun.
That's excellent. I know what you're saying when talking with the transportation group. Prior to my life in the sign industry, I was in the aluminum industry, but I worked a lot with TAC, Transportation Association of Canada. And I kind of fit right in with that group as well, because, you know, being so nerdy and geeky and engineering types, it suited me kind of well. So I get what you're coming from, but when I get over to this industry and it's square pegs and round holes, and
that's right.
It made it a little hard for me to convert. So, but then you got guys like Lee who, you know, it's no problem for them to do stuff like that, right?
Yeah, there you go.
I think Robert and I are exactly like your two industries, where Robert represents the boring one and I represent the sexy, creative, fun one.
Oh, okay.
Don't tell him I said that. I don't know if he's sitting beside me. I don't know what side he's on, or if he's on the bottom or whatever. But...
Oh, yeah. Thanks a lot, buddy. I appreciate that one. So I'm old and boring now, Tanya. That's what you get when you work with a young guy, okay?
There you go.
So where do you see the industry going now? Where do you see the future of the sign industry, according to Tanya?
Well, I thought a lot about this, and I want to just say two things about it. One is, I got to say, I'm in the situation that we are in right now with COVID-19. I am thoroughly impressed at how fast our graphics manufacturers have pivoted and have come up with innovative solutions to fit the current customer needs and beyond. So that goes into, you know, floor graphics, for example, have, you know, consistently kind of been an ignored application, not very popular. And now they're the most popular graphics that some graphics manufacturers are producing, social distancing graphics. And so I see that's not temporary. I see that that's something more that's going to be long-term for social distancing on window graphics, sidewalks, and floors. So I just wanted to say I'm thoroughly impressed. I think that will continue. Also, you know, looking at some antimicrobial or antiviruses types of films, I don't have any intel right now. I can tell you from 3M, but hopefully there will be more films like that that'll need to be installed. You know, how long will we be a little uncertain about going to hotels, touching touch screens and things like that? So there's a market there for some of those films. And the other future initiative, which is at a core for 3M, is sustainability. And I really think it translates into the industry. We focus a lot on sustainability, and I think there will be more of a push in the future for companies to use the circular economy and sustainable products that can be reused, refinished, and things are not ending up in a landfill. So a lot of green products right from the production to refinishing things that you already have, or using less hardware or LEDs and things like that to save energy. So sustainability, I think, is where we're going.
Mm. When you say microbiological? Films?
Oh, antimicrobial?
What exactly is that?
Well, there's certain films out there, and I don't know all the ins and outs of all the films, but ones that, you know, can reduce bacteria and reduce the transfer of bacteria on film. So, you know, when you're going into a retail setting and you go for grab a shopping cart, films, I'm being, you know, my thinking mind, films that can go on handles and such that can either be cleaned with abrasive chemicals. So there's some films, you know, that you can't clean very well. They're either going to damage the over laminate or damage the graphic. So, or these type of films that can go on handles of doors, you know, normally maybe not all buildings have automatic doors. Are we going to be comfortable pulling and pushing doors in the future, grabbing your grocery cart and not wiping it down? I you know, this post-COVID-19 world just brings all kinds of, I guess, new maybe opportunities is a way to look at it, new challenges that I think some of these films, if invented, can fit that need that, you know, will make people feel more comfortable touching counters. You think of all the things you touch when you go into a store. It could be clothing, hangers, anything, right? So so there's just, you know, it's a lengthy process to get these films approved. I think there's an opportunity for it for sure.
I don't think I've heard anyone in our industry even hint at that being a direction. So hats off to you. I would have never considered that.
Maybe I should be a scientist. Should be in the lab.
If this happens, we're going to call you the inventor of Post-its because you heard it here first.
I want the patent.
From 3M said it.
Right here on our show, she's letting us know.
Oh, there you go. I hope they're looking at it. You know, I don't have direct access to the scientists in the lab, but I see a window there, and I've had some inquiries from customers, you know, about such films and what do we look like, you know, in April of 2021? What is our graphics industry going to look like, and how will things change? I think someone compared what we're going through now to 9/11. We never flew the same way and traveled through an airport the same way after 9/11. And some people are comparing COVID-19 and what we're going through now. We will never move around this world the same way as we did before February.
And your insight into the film solution is something I believe you're right. It will be pertinent because people think of signage and graphics. And the print industry is, you don't necessarily have to print on the actual vinyl. You can just use the vinyl as a solution and then teach people the proper way to install it, hire a certified installation company, et cetera, et cetera. So that, I agree 100%. That's a great insight.
Thank you.
Yeah, you got a background in graphics and vinyl application, don't you, Lee?
I do, but I feel like I'm going to sound a little uneducated with Tanya on the show.
Oh, yeah. Come on.
She speaks right over my head, you know, so.
As far as I know, 3M makes car wrap vinyl, but that probably speaks to my age.
We do.
You know, he rubs it in there quite often, every chance he gets.
I like it.
Yeah, okay. So, Tanya, just to finish up here, tell us about you. What is it you like to do when you're not working, when you're at home, kids, husband, what do you do on the weekends? Tell us all about that.
Sure. So everybody at 3M chuckles at me. So a little bit about my kids. I have a stepson, Max, who will be 18 this month. And then my two boys are Mitchell and Mason. So yes, I have 3Ms. And everybody always chuckles that I did that on purpose. It's a little bit on purpose, a little bit not. But I have a Max, a Mitchell, and a Mason.
Wow.
It's all boys in my house, so it's a lot of Lego and loud Nerf guns. I'm constantly being shot with Nerf guns, but a lot of fun. So something we love to do, we do have a camper trailer, and we have our little posse of campers, so we spend a lot of time outside. We go camping basically every time we can in the summer, and make sure our kids are outside and getting lots of fresh air. So we love doing that. I love gardening. I've already cleaned up my gardens when we had some warm weather last weekend. So love watching my perennials come up through the ground this time of year. And love spending time doing that. And then I have a big love of music. So I love to sing. And I always play around with I used to play piano. I play around a little bit with my guitar. My son plays bass guitar, ukulele, violin. And so anywhere you'll find me, I'm always known as the DJ in the family playing music or singing something. So those are things that keep me busy.
I don't sing, and it's for your benefit. Trust me.
Okay.
What type of music?
You know what? My mom was big country music fan. So I like a lot of old country, but then my dad's rock and roll. So anything from Eagles, CCR, Steve Miller Band's probably one of my favorite bands. So I have a little bit of both of my parents in me when it comes to music, Fleetwood Mac, right up to, you know, Garth Brooks. So anything that falls in between would be probably my favorites for
I'm
sure.
I'm looking at you right now, Lee. That's old people's music, okay?
Listen, I just found out that Tanya can sing. Tanya, I didn't know that about you. I don't know if you know about Robert, that Robert can professionally dance. So,
hey, I can't wait to see that.
I've witnessed it in person. I'm not lying that it's Dancing with the Stars quality. So it's Sign Expo Canada this year. You're going to sing, play the piano. Robert's going to dance. I'm going to get the whole thing on video.
I love it.
No, 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 no.
Well, let's keep our fingers crossed that we can do that if things improve, that we'll be together at Sign Expo in September.
If not, we'll do a virtual Sign Expo.
Virtual, okay.
Virtual Sign Expo. Yeah,
thank you for being with us, Tanya. And before we let you go, if anyone wants to get in contact with you, do you want to tell people your email, your website, anything of that nature?
Oh, sure. Yeah, my email, it's a little difficult, but it's my full name, T-L, and then my last name is Mailhot, M-A-I-L-H-O-T, at mmm.com. Or my cell phone's pretty easy, 902-237-6633. Probably the best ways.
Tanya, thank you so much for doing this. And we'll notify you when this gets posted up to the page. So thank you
Fantastic.
Very, very much.
Thanks again for the opportunity. Do this, don't do that, get your wheels.